money, money, money.
The profits were staggering, up to $1 million a week.
Should we throw these ones away, man, since we got $500,000?
Well, I tell you what we can do. We can give it to the poor.
That's exactly what I said, too. We'll just donate those to the poor.
If money can be the difference as far as me being sad and happy, hey, I want as much money as I can get, you understand me?
Of course, I aspired to become a drug dealer. I went from wanting to become a lawyer to becoming a criminal. Well, this one particular guy I knew, his name was Banana. He was moving drugs, a few ounces here and there. So I approached him, I said, I want to become a part of this. Can you hook me up in some type of way? And, you know, I'll pay you back as quick as I can. He was like, cool, you know what I'm saying? You my nigga, so I'll hook you up and you just come and fuck with me from now on. The first ounce that I received on consignment from Banana, I actually didn't know what to do with it. Banana had to instruct me on how to properly transform powder cocaine into crack cocaine.
It's basically an art form not everyone can do. Through practice, I would say I became the Michael Jordan of crack cookers. What you do, you get powder cocaine and you put baking soda on the powder cocaine. You put it in a glass coffee pot. You put water in the coffee pot. You put it on a stove, and in about 5 minutes or so, the powder cocaine turns into a yellow gel-like liquid. From there, you remove it from the flame. You throw in a few ice cubes to reduce the heat. And at the same time, you constantly rotate the coffee pot in a counterclockwise motion. You throw in a few more ice cubes and you reduce the heat even further. By now, the rock is forming. You put it under the faucet. You add cold water to completely harden that rock. Once it's hardened, you take it out of the coffee pot, put it on a plate, and you take a large knife or a meat cleaver or what have you, and you break it down
into $10 pieces, $20 pieces,
into crack cocaine.